Well, we have a very active group known as Center for Community and Environmental Justice. They are a very active group. They are always advocate for the healthful air in the region, not only in our neighborhood and our cities, but other cities in the area where there is a high concentration of pollution.
Well, over the last 20 or 30 years, possibly more, this has been an epicenter for industry, for warehouses, and of course, trucks coming from the docks and from also from out of state.
Mira Loma has been one of those areas that has not only high pollution, but also high unemployment, high poverty levels. It has a lack of services. It doesn't have access to health care and fresh vegetables. And so Mira Loma has been the area that we focused on since about 1997, when we first started seeing the warehouses come in and the conversion of a rural community into an industrialized area. In our area, the particulate pollution that we're concerned about comes from diesel exhaust. And diesel exhaust is linked to a number of health problems, from not only respiratory illnesses, because the particles get deep into the lungs and they're hard to expel. And the smaller the particles, the deeper they get into it, until you reach a point where there's some that the ultrafines that actually travel through the cell membrane, get into the bloodstream, and impact the brain, the heart, and other parts of the body. So we're seeing brain tumors, we're seeing cardiovascular disease, and we're even seeing birth defects in low-weight babies.
I wanted to thank you all for volunteering to be here and help with this. We've been working a long time with this community in order to address the pollution problems that they have here. This has the highest particulate pollution in the state of California, right where you're sitting right now. And so when they proposed to put more warehouses right at the fence line of these homes, right on the other side of there, we decided that was it. We had to do something and do it very strongly. So we sued the developer. We were joined by the Attorney General of the state of California, Kamala Harris, and we were able to get a really groundbreaking settlement. The settlement calls for these terrific high-performance air filtration units to be put on every one of the homes here, which will help them immensely. There is an average of 800 trucks an hour that go past these homes less than 20 feet from their backyards. So having those air purification systems there will make their lives indoors a lot better. These filters are key to helping these families. We've already used them on 7 schools. So we've worked with IQAir and putting them in San Bernardino to help with the students' health. And so this is the first one we've done with residential.
Well, I'm certainly pleased that finally they get some resolution out of the bad air that they've been breathing over the last several years. Penny has done a stellar job at making this area right here in particular very healthy for the residents.
A lot of people don't have internet, they don't have email, they've got it. It takes an individual conversation. It takes saying, hi, you know, I'm from this community group. I want to talk to you about air quality in your neighborhood. That's what it takes. So it's really these guys that are such amazing heroes, because that's what they do day in and day out. They knock on doors through a conversation. They're actually changing the world through a conversation. So it's pretty amazing.
You know, I think as much joy as I take in having a victory, I mean, because we've fought really hard alongside with the residents, it is the residents that, you know, have been facing challenges for years, and they really didn't believe anything was ever going to change. And so to prove to them that if they come together in one voice and they're targeted and they're persistent, they can win things. That is the biggest joy for me. They're now believers. They do believe things can happen. And that in turn will make it easier to move forward to take on the other challenges that this community undoubtedly will have.